Jūs jau vėl dėjo.
Sakė, aš išmokinau jūs, kad sako, jūs visi sireikiuosite ir sako, kai aš pakviesiu
jūs. Jūs jau vėl dėjo.
Kurio vardą pakviesi, tas yra teisti. Pakviesi, čia vardą ir taip atėjo.
This is Miles. He is the guy that I told you. I'll show you on the paper, but where is the paper? This schedule. So, this is Miles, out of Calimero, the one, the son of Athos with Eurotitania, who got lost with Maya, the granddaughter of the International Barcelona. This is Miles. And I must tell you, this was the most pleasant surprise that I had in years. When I was revisiting my pedigrees. When I came here to Lithuania, I had two pigeons who looked very much alike. Calimero. And Amigo. Amigo was a son of Don Hidalgo. Calimero was a son of Athos. Now, in these first weeks, when I told you that I had a number of pigeons who died, one died. They were from the two who looked so much alike, had the same color of ring, and I need glasses to read my rings.
Yeah.
And I pretend to know my pigeons.
Oh.
Okay, one dies, and I was sure it was Calimero who died. And I was pissed off because I lost the line of Athos.
Nu, va, kad ta linija prarado, kad Calimero mirė, bet sako, jis nieko nemato be akinių, po to pakeitė ten ant žiedo, tik tai, kad ne tas gal mirė,
bet
praeitą savaitę, kad galvo, kad visą liniją prarado.
Last year, my neighbor girl, Aida, she made photos of all my pigeons that I had, and she wrote down the name and the ring number. Now, I am revisiting my documentary that she makes. And I say, but this ring number, that is not the ring. We write Amigo, but it is not the ring number of Amigo, it's the ring number of Calimero. I went to look up in my notes from Belgium and I say, God, it was Amigo who died and not Calimero, but Calimero was already escaped at that moment. But I had the photo that Ida made with the ring number that she had noted, that I didn't make tilt at that moment. It was only when I was revisiting for errors in my pedigrees that I fell on this. And so, but that Amigo died was no big deal because I still had his brother, Titan. But the other one was the only one of this side of the line. And this is
a... Oh, okay.
That is also the reason he was last year on the show with his pedigree, but it was the wrong pedigree at that moment.
Please ring number.
Barcelona, ne, turėtume pamatyti.
Mm. Koks ramus paukštis.
Said very quiet bird.
Oh, yes. He should be called the sleeper or the dreamer or something like that. But if one comes, whoop, he don't argue. You do that? Directly he's not sleeping anymore.
Oi. Sorry, very nice pigeon.
Very soft, eh?
Yeah.
Very soft, eh? And I give nothing, eh? I give nothing. Nothing special. Hey boy. Mijn vriendje, hè? Dat is het, mijn vriend. Okay, Phoenix.
Visas gyvenimas šitie paukščiai.
Go, Phoenix, get.
Va, čia toks jau. Felix.
Didesnis.
Hey, Phoenix. This is Phoenix.
Felix.
Phoenix.
No, Felix. Phoenix.
Phoenix.
Like the firebird out of mythology.
Kaip ugninis paukštis iš mitologijos.
Taip, Feniksas.
Can you keep him for a moment?
Ką Donis matai ypatinga paskai.
Na tai jis tavęs bija.
Lengvas, nu toks plunksnas, porus atrodo.
Ateik, čia va,
prie šiuo. Minkštas plunksnas. Nu man parodys.
That's why he is called Phoenix.
Kodėl tipo Phoenix'o tipo jis pavadinis rodo?
Kad panašus.
This is the photo of the mankaroja, 1953, the basic pigeon of Roger van Gulik.
Mhm.
Can you imagine this? He is older than I am. And this is exactly the replica of him.
Žiedą.
Turi tą senobišką savyje kažką tai braižą.
He's Belgian breed. He's one who came in the truck up to here.
How old?
13.
Sakas, su sunkvežimi atvažiavo.
From 13, eh?
13 metų, jo.
Four. He's now an adult, eh?
Dabar saugus.
Hey boy. Is it mene vriend, eh? Mene vriend.
Pavadina berne.
In a minute, Glenna, friend. You see, very soft, very bella. Three things are important. Origin.
Kilmė.
Balance.
Mm-hmm.
And confirmation. Confirmation.
What confirmation? What?
A good wing is not confirmation. It is a part of confirmation. A good head and a good eye is not confirmation. It's part of confirmation. Good muscles. It's not confirmation, it's part of confirmation. Confirmation is... There are these so-called secrets. A pigeon needs to have a good eye. A pigeon needs to have a good wing. A pigeon needs to have good... muscles. Forget it. When you have a pigeon with a good eye...
Gerai, kim kada...
But nothing but a good eye,
nieko, bet gerą
he will do nothing.
Sako, nieko nepadarys.
When you have a pigeon with a perfect wing, but nothing more than that, he will do nothing. When you have a pigeon with a good conformation, he can be only 90% for the eye, 85% for the wing, 76% for the muscles, 98% in softness, but in this integrality, he is one piece. And he is in the conformation of the origin of this pigeon. And he is well balanced.
Mm-hmm.
Then you have a good chance that you have a decent pigeon. And a decent pigeon does not need to be a champion on the flights. He can be a normal pigeon in racing, but giving good pigeons. And that I'm telling you. One thing is for sure. If you have pigeons who come out of a long line of champion birds, the father of Barcelona too has never seen a basket, but his father was a champion. Barcelona too was a champion, but both Red Alice and Prince Barca, the father of the international ace pigeon, have never seen a basket.
Mm-hmm.
But they gave champions. The three musketeers of 2000, they all three flew Barcelona in 2003. And they all three were in the prizes. One on 10. So, in the 10 first, if there are 100 pigeons. But that are not the prizes that I'm interested in.
Mm-hmm.
The first 100 national, that counts for me. But when they can fly one on 10, you can be sure that they have potential. That they are good. If they don't can fly a 1 on 10 on a flight like Barcelona, Dax, Perpignan, forget it. Forget it. And with that kind of pigeons, you can continue. But since 2003, I have had in Belgium so much trouble. My father died in 2003. And in Zwendrecht, where we lived, the lofts were on the name of my father. And in this village, this story is, a Lithuanian person cannot understand this. This Belgian bureaucratic absurdity.
Mm-hmm.
As long as my father lived, everything was okay. My father dies, I live there, on the same roof, the pigeons were raised on my name, but the loft permission was on the name of my father.
Mm-hmm.
Well, my father died, and they said, it is here a die-out project. Well, you cannot have your lofts anymore, but I have my permission to keep pigeons here. Yes, you can keep your pigeons, but you can't keep your lofts. But where do I have to put them? That is your problem, sir. So, from one day on another, I had to break down my lofts. So, I buy another house. And I move to Wallonia. In the middle of the woods. No neighbors. No problems. Europe makes it Euro 2000 zone. You cannot construct. I bought a house in the time that I organized to have my loft built. This decree came out, came law. They knew it when they sold the house to me. But they never told me. So I couldn't construct there. So I had to look another place to keep my pigeons. Then in the meantime, I got trouble with my the guy who I had bought some apartment blocks. And the guy who had to do the transformations, he, well, he didn't do his, let's put it nicely, he didn't do his part of the job. The renovation was not done, but the renovation was well factored to me. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Okay? Okay? I went to, then I went to justice. He had the expert that was nominated was his architect. So there were no errors found. And then I got, then my wife left me because she was afraid of the financial consequences. That was 2010. And then I gave up. And then I moved to a little place in Hastier. I took my pigeons with me. I took my dog and my parrot with me, and I got. Mm-hmm. I didn't want to have to do with anyone anymore. And then my neighbor in front of me, he was never there. Because he stayed in Lithuania. Because he found a Lithuanian woman. And when they came over.
Sorry. Who found Lithuanian woman? Your neighbor?
My neighbor in front of me in this at this little house in Hastiere.
And he offered you to come here.
And when he came here, he said, Ivan, instead of sitting